Greetings. New YouTube policy changes allow them to post ads for their profit on every video they host. My account is not monetized and never has been. Feel free to skip any ads shown or use the Brave browser. Greetings. Let's continue with part 2, examining Deedat's combat kit and apostasy. Point 6, apostasy. Neither shall thine eye pity him, the apostate, neither shalt thou spare him, neither shalt thou conceal him, but thou shalt surely kill him. Thine hand shall be first upon him to put him to death. Deuteronomy 13:89. It is nice to not have another absurd grocery list of absurdity. In fact, this topic only references one verse of scripture from Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 13:89. When I first saw this, I thought, my, that is an interesting new reference format. Dash, not colon. Okay, Deedat's joke was on Muslims. I looked for 13:89, and it does not exist. Deedat really meant Deuteronomy 13, verse 8 and 9. Just a tiny nit that speaks to the mindlessness of Islam. The author of this pamphlet was so careless, he probably never proofread it, including any scripture references. This indicates 13-89 and not 13 verse 8 through 9. Here is an actual image of the PDF that circulates to this day. Deuteronomy 1 space 3 space dash 8 space 9. I wonder if any Muslim has ever known or cared enough to correct Deedat's gross errors. This is part 2, and I plan to consider the cited reference in context, and if time permits, other relevant commands and teachings. Let's first understand what the Bible says in the context of the Old Testament, and then consider New Testament teachings. Deuteronomy 13:1. If a prophet or dreamer of dreams arises among you and proclaims a sign or wonder to you, and if the sign or wonder he has spoken to you comes about, notice, this says, if the sign or wonder comes about, if it happens. But he says, let us follow other gods which you have not known, and let us worship them, like pagan deities from foreign lands, with different names, like Allah, which is a foreign name. If Muslims claim they are the same, Muslims should drop all mention of Allah and worship Jehovah. You must not listen to the words of that prophet or dreamer. For the Lord your God is testing you to find out whether you love Him with all your heart and with all your soul. We are not to follow the signs or wonders. You are to follow Jehovah, the Lord your God, and fear Him. Keep His commandments and listen to His voice. Serve Him and hold fast to Him. Such a prophet or dreamer must be put to death, because he has advocated rebellion against Jehovah, the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt and redeemed you from the house of slavery. He has tried to turn you from the way in which Jehovah, the Lord your God, has commanded you to walk. So you must purge the evil from among you. The revelation of God, through Moses, clearly states a false prophet is an evil that must be purged. God does not project what they are thinking or say to avoid their friendship. In this regime, Muhammad would have been stoned to death by the people of the book. If Muhammad had ever been to Israel or Jerusalem, if your very own brother or your son or daughter or the wife you embrace or your closest friend, who are we talking about here? People you know, love, respect, your closest friend. If any of these people secretly entices you, saying, let us go and worship other gods, which neither you nor your fathers have known, this is talking of your most intimate confidants, secretly drawing you from Jehovah. Only a few verses earlier, Moses wrote that, For the Lord your God is testing you to find out whether you love him with all your heart and with all your soul. Now, this is becoming very personal. Who do you love the most? Really? This reminds me of the Lord Jesus speak of leaving father and mother and family for him, for God. Who do we love more? Mark 10:29. Jesus said, "Truly I say to you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the gospel." And this is not just a calculated economic strategy. Do you love God, which neither you nor your fathers have known, the gods of the peoples around you, whether near or far, whether from one end of the earth to or the other? It does not matter where they come from or what they claim. Rest assured, no Hebrew-speaking Hebrew ever heard the word Allah promoted by a prophet of Jehovah God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The pagan deity Allah is not the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, named Jehovah, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. So that is the context of the verses Deedat attempts to rape and hold up to ridicule. We now get to Deuteronomy 13:8. You must not yield to him or listen to him. Show him no pity and do not spare him or shield him. Remember, we are talking about your closest relationships. Instead, you must surely kill him. Your hand must be the first against him to put him to death, and then the hands of all the people. And this is the pair of verses Deedat hopes to hold up to ridicule as a shameful example. Let's dig into it just like we did into the ayat of the Quran. You must not yield to him or listen to him. Show him no pity and do not spare him or shield him. 9a. Instead, you must surely kill him. B. Your hand must be the first against him to put him to death. C. And then the hands of all the people. You must not yield to him or listen to him. Show him no pity and do not spare him or shield him. Don't yield, so don't agree or consent. Don't show pity. This is not the time for charity or forgiveness. This person has unknowingly, possibly, sought to condemn you to hell. You, the person they sought to entice you to worship other gods, not named Jehovah. If your own brother, or your son, or daughter, or the wife you embrace, or your closest friend, secretly entices you, saying, "Let us go and worship other gods." This is not hollow projection. This is not imaginary mind reading of how Muhammad said to imagine the apostates think. A specific damning action was taken by them against your eternity. Quran 489, they wish. Deuteronomy 13:6, entice you, secretly entice you, saying. Can you see the difference? Muhammad teaches fear of what someone might be thinking. God is condemning the action that has actually happened. Instead, you must surely kill him. You were the intended victim. You who were offered the enticement, the seduction. You who witnessed this act of rebellion against Jehovah God. Your hand must be the first against him to put him to death. You were the intended victim. You must be the first. You are told to cast the first stone. Compare that to Mohammedism's general command for any Muslim to kill any apostate wherever you find them. And then the hands of all the people. There must be community involvement. This is not a secret personal vendetta. You must not yield to him or listen to him. Show him no pity and do not spare him or shield him. Instead, you must surely kill him. Your hand must be the first against him to put him to death, and then the hands of all the people. Notice this is sudden justice. He tried to seduce you to follow a pagan deity, maybe named Allah. You are to be the first against him, right then, not wherever, whenever you happen to find him, somewhere down the road, down the way. Stone him to death for trying to turn you away from Jehovah, the Lord, your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. Turn you from Jehovah to follow Satan, calling himself any other name, even Allah. Never, never, ever, ever accept praying to Allah as equivalent to or a substitute for praying to Jesus, Yeshua, or Jehovah God. Then all Israel will hear and be afraid, and will never again do such a wicked thing among you. Should anyone who respects Jehovah God be ashamed in the least by this command revealed by Prophet Moses? No. I will not apologize for Jehovah God, the Creator, laying down the law. God knows the end from before the beginning, and he knew in advance what it would take for his people to survive and his eternal plan to come to fruition. And shock! Spoiler! God even knew humans would sin. Adam in the garden, Prophet David, Moses, and Jehovah God giving a command to kill false prophets is different than a false prophet saying a pagan deity named Allah told him to say, kill those that leave my religion. Jehovah is God. That is his name. Isaiah 42:8. I am Jehovah, the Lord. That is my name. And my glory I will not give to another, nor my praise to carved images. If you want to worship a false deity by another name, I suggest you do not do it in Israel, at least while they were under the Old Testament dispensation of the prophets. And this is not a New Testament command to kill Christians who leave Christianity. And I'll get to that in part 3. This is another tragic, fatal ignorance in Islam. It is the responsibility of Christians to know the truth and then be able to share and teach the truth with clear scriptural facts. The time of the Gentiles is coming to an end, and too many Christians do not even know what that means or what it portends. Luke 21:36. But keep alert at all times. Be attentive and ready, praying that you may have the strength and ability to be found worthy and to escape all these things that are going to take place and to stand in the presence of the Son of Man at his coming. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.